सुश्री सुष्मिता देव।
थैंक यू चेयरमैन सर। टुडे माय पार्टी हैज गिवन मी एन अपॉर्चुनिटी टू स्पीक ऑन अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट बिल, द वाइल्ड लाइफ प्रोटेक्शन अमेंडमेंट बिल। एंड आई हैव टू से दैट इट इज बीन माय प्रिविलेज टू स्पीक बिफोर यू फॉर द सेकेंड टाइम इन अ स्पैन ऑफ वेरी फ्यू डेज। सो आई हैव बीन लिसनिंग टू माय लर्नड कोलीग्स and very valuable suggestions have been put forth about wildlife as a whole, and it's extremely significant for me because I come from the state of Assam, however elected by my leader Mamata Banerjee from West Bengal, but I come from a region where forest, flora, fauna are very integral part of our economy, of our livelihoods and of our society, sir. As you know that the northeastern states have actually geographical coverage of 7.98% of the country's forest coverage is in the northeastern states. So this bill is particularly very close to my heart, but I have to start by saying that this is one such bill, Chairman sir, where one cannot just concentrate on the sections or clauses that are in the principle that have been amended in the principal act, but actually the thrust of this bill is in the number of schedules that have been included. Us din aap bol rahe the ki expertise, kuch aise bills hote hain jiske liye expertise ki bahut zarurat hoti hai, ye waisa hi ek bill hai. And I applaud the members of the standing committee because I feel that they have done a thorough job. They have heard a number of activists, environmentalists, experts, and then made the amendments or given their suggestions to this bill. Sir, we are well aware that as a nation we are amongst the about 184 countries that have signed the International Convention on International Trade in Endangered Species of Wild Fauna and Flora 1975. If I'm not wrong, we signed it and ratified it sometime in 1976, and this bill became absolutely necessary to bring our current laws in line with our international obligations under that treaty. Sir, having said that, I would like to say that when it was first introduced in the Lok Sabha in December 21, the standing committee went through a very thorough discussion. Then it was passed in the Lok Sabha, and now it is before us for consideration again. If I may say so, that this bill is a prime example of how a standing committee can act as a watchdog of the nation, sir. Today we should, as all of us members of the House, whether they're in the Treasury bench or the opposition bench, we must all come together in agreeing that it is a disservice to the nation if the number of bills that go to the standing committee drops from 60% to 13%. So today I'm a member of parliament, but I don't have every expertise. So it is an opportunity for me to read the standing committee report and learn it. So here I would like to say कि हम कानून किसके लिए बनाते हैं? हम एक साधारण इंसान के लिए कानून बनाते हैं जिन पर ये कानून लागू होता है, और हमारा ये कर्तव्य है एज लॉ मेकर्स, इट इज आर ड्यूटी टू सिंप्लीफाई द लॉ. वरना आर ऑनरेबल मिनिस्टर इज वेरी लर्नड, आई हैव सैट इन द एनवायरमेंटल स्टैंडिंग कमिटी विद हिम एंड लर्नड अ लॉट फ्रॉम हिम, बट हर इंसान के पास उस समझने की ताकत नहीं होती. This bill, the way it has been amended, and standing committee has repeatedly said that it has become a very cumbersome bill, sir. It has become a very cumbersome bill, and a question that many people in this arena raised is that what is the reason that this was not made a part of the Biological Diversity Act 2002, the amendment for which is also pending in a 2021 bill before the joint committee. अगर इसको बायोलॉजिकल डायवर्सिटी एक्ट के माध्यम से लाया जाता है इस अमेंडमेंट को, हमारा ये मानना है इट वुड हैव बीन फार मोर स्ट्रीमलाइंड. माय लर्नड कोलीग मिस्टर सिन्हा spoke a lot about biological diversity, which only bolsters my point that that may have been a better drafting strategy to insert it in the Biological Diversity Act. No one can oppose this bill, sir. No one can oppose this bill because we all agree on sustainable exploitation of our flora and fauna. And it is a reality. It is a reality, sir, that the kind of international trade that takes place of plants and wildlife specimens runs into billions of dollars. It's a huge area for legislation. It was much required, so I do not oppose that. But I would also like to say that this kind of exploitation also leads to a massive threat. Also leads through a massive threat. So therefore, to implement sites was extremely important for us. One of the key amendments that has been brought is to have two authorities, one being the management authority, sir, and one being the scientific authority. Sir, these two authorities will regulate the trade of these species as well as they will ensure that the level of the trade doesn't go to such an extent that it becomes detrimental to any species. Sir, this is important, I don't deny it, because our sustainable development goals number 15 is also very important to us when it comes to wildlife. But I do feel, sir, that in the composition of these two authorities, one must remember that this is a subject that is in the concurrent list. And therefore, the states must have a significant say in how it is implemented. So these two authorities, how they will be set up, who will run it, which set of officers, must take into account our strong principles of federalism and help the states to be constructively they should be able to constructively engage at the level of these authorities, sir. Sir, I am pained to say that many members have repeatedly raised the concern about the way the Section 43 has been amended. Section 43 has been amended of the Principal Act, which is the 1972 Act. And this is not a concern of parliamentarians or members of the standing committee, but this is a concern of people who have been fighting for decades for the protection of captive animals like the elephants. Sir, if I may say so, हमने देखा था एक जमाना था जब राजा महाराजा हाथी पे चढ़ के युद्ध पे जाते थे. मुझे याद है बचपन के वो दिन जब हम रिपब्लिक डे में देखते थे कि साहसी बच्चों को हाथियों पर बिठाकर परेड में ले जाते थे. पर इस देश में हमने उन कानूनों में या उन रिचुअल्स में हम परिवर्तन लेके आए. क्यों लेके आए? उस पशु के हित में जिसको जंगल में होना चाहिए, पर वो हमारे बीच में है, उसमें थोड़ा हमारा स्वार्थ है. सो वेदर ऑल ऑफ अस पार्लियामेंटेरियंस रियलाइज दैट a wild elephant, sir, in this country comes under captive animals. Aur mera ye manna hai ki humne Republic Day ke parade mein bhi elephants ko use karna, sir, band kar diya. It has been declared as a heritage animal. Mr. Jairam Ramesh, I think, was at that time the minister. Aur jo clause 27 ye sarkar leke aayi hai, sir, it is a direct contravention of the earlier section 43. I'm sure Honorable Minister is very learned. He will explain himself. Standing committee ke bilkul vipreet amendment leke aaye, sir, jo Lok Sabha mein pass hokar aaj Rajya Sabha mein aayi hai. Original Act says you cannot transfer any captive animal for consideration. So what are the exceptions? Like you move an animal from one zoo to the other, no one can say anything. And moment you move them, you have to inform the chief wildlife warden within 30 days. Sir, is section ko badal ke sarkar ne jo parivartan, jo amendment, sangshodhan, sorry, leke aaye hain, usme likh diya ki live elephants, jo owners hai, jinke paas certificate hai, they can transfer and transport with the permission of the state government on fulfillment of such conditions as may be prescribed by the central government. ह्यूज डिस्क्रेशन सर. इसमें पर्पस तक नहीं लिखा. स्टैंडिंग कमिटी लेट गिव अ वेरी प्रैक्टिकल सजेशन. वी रियलाइज द ग्राउंड रियलिटीज ऑफ दिस नेशन एंड एलिफेंट्स फॉर्म अ पार्ट ऑफ आर रिचुअल्स. सो आई प्लीड विद द ऑनरेबल मिनिस्टर कि सर आपने जो एनी अदर पर्पस करके और भी इसको ब्रॉड कर दिया, उसकी वजह से पब्लिक डोमेन में एक डर है जिस डर की वजह आप समझते हैं सर. बिकॉज अगर एलिफेंट्स और एक इम्पॉर्टेंट तथ्य देके मैं अंत करूंगी, मेरा टाइम अप होने वाला है, कि आई वॉन्ट द ऑनरेबल मिनिस्टर टू टेल द पार्लियामेंट दैट वॉट इज द रीजन दैट दिस गवर्नमेंट डिड नॉट वोट अगेंस्ट द मोशन वेयर इंटरनेशनल ट्रेड फॉर आइवरी वॉज ड्यू टू बी स्टार्टेड. That motion was defeated, but this government abstained from voting. So any other purpose और उसके बीच में कोई संबंध तो नहीं है सर. ये पूछना शायद लोकतंत्र में मेरा हक है. आपका बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद. पार्टी का बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद.
श्री जयराम रमेश.